Funding for this video series is generously provided by the University of Idaho Extension's Innovative Project Award. Welcome! This is the last video in this video series on Understanding International Trade, the Basic Ideas. Episode 4, Winners and Losers of Trade. If you recall in Episode 1, we showed that countries benefit from free trade. So, how come if trade is good, why are people against free trade? In this video, we will explore this question and also examine the issue of tariffs. So, let's review the last two questions we asked in the introduction video. The questions are, true or false, if trade between two countries is voluntary and fair, then everyone in both countries should benefit from trade. True or false, if a tariff is placed on our imports, and other countries don't put a retaliatory tariff on a good I'm exporting, then the tariff doesn't affect us. These two questions are related and slightly more complicated than the previous questions we have discussed. To answer these questions, let's meet Joe's friend, John, a business owner. John is a memory chip producer. Before Joe went to Mars, John usually sells his memory chips to Joe at $2 per unit. He has been lonely lately after Joe came back from Mars. The reason is very simple. Joe gets his memory chips from Martians now at $1. To stay in the business, John is forced to lower his price to $1 to compete with Martians. Otherwise, his business will fail. In this case, trade hurts John's business. The short answer to question 4 is false, since trade creates winners and losers within a country. It is important to note that trade is not a zero-sum game. When two countries trade with each other, it's not that one country will win and the other country will lose. Trade is actually a non-zero-sum game. So there are benefits to both countries. When economists say there is a gain from trade, what they really mean is, if we compare the national income, in this case, Joe's plus John's, before and after trade, free trade helps to increase the national income. For instance, producers in a country's exporting sector record a gain. Joe receives a higher price from selling his potato chips to Martians. But it doesn't mean everyone's income will go up. Producers in a country's importing sector lose. John must compete with the Martians and lower his memory chips price and production. This means that consumers gain from buying cheaper imported goods, but lose by paying more on the exported goods. Therefore, if the winner's gain is greater than the loser's loss, there is gain from trade in each sector. Similarly, when Martians export memory chips and import potato chips, there are also winners and losers in each sector. But overall, the Martians still benefit from trade. Now, let's look at question 5. True or false, if a tax or tariff is placed on what we import, and other countries don't put a retaliatory tariff on a good that we are exporting, then the tariff doesn't affect us. Next, let's examine why the answer to that question is false. Suppose there's a tariff on imported memory chips. Due to the tariff, the price of memory chips will go up, and Joe will buy fewer memory chips from Martians. John is happy to be protected. But should Joe be concerned about this policy? Of course, Joe as a consumer is not happy to pay a higher price to buy the memory chips. On the other side, Joe may find his sales on potato chips are going down. Why is that? The short answer is, Martians rely on the income from their memory chip business to pay for the potato chips. The tariff that helped John hurt the Martians' business and consequently their income. Therefore, they can't afford as many of Joe's potato chips. Joe worries about upsetting the Martians by imposing a tariff. The Martians could put a tariff on Joe's potato chips in retaliation. If the Martians put a tariff on potato chip imports, then some potato chips that normally would ship to Mars will stay in the local market, and the surplus in supply may drive down the price of Joe's potato chips, hurt his business, and lower his income. Based on the possible gains from free trade, economists would say that, at the country level, unlike the win-win payoff under free trade, a trade war will lead to a lose-lose for both countries. An import tariff is one of the most widely used trade policy. However, without considering the political effects, such a trade intervention does not make much economic sense. Economists suggest that free trade is better. So, how do we move toward free trade? One possibility is countries enter into a trade agreement, which is a pact to reduce or eliminate trade barriers between themselves. For example, we can think of the World Trade Organization as a multilateral trade agreement, involving many countries with agreement to lower tariffs among all the members. There are also regional trade agreements, involving fewer countries, often located near each other, such as the USMCA, which the members include the United States, Mexico, and Canada, and the Trans-Pacific Partnership establishes a free trade area among 11 countries that border the Pacific Ocean. And so far, we have introduced some basic questions in international trade in this video series. Thank you for watching these videos. We hope that you will find this as a benefit personally and potentially in helping your business. Please stay tuned for our next video series.